Welcome, viewers, to an enthralling journey through two of the globe's most vibrant and captivating realms, the dazzling Las Vegas casino industry and the adrenaline-fueled financial markets of Wall Street. At first glance, these worlds seem worlds apart. One, a playground of lights and luck in the heart of the Nevada desert. The other, the epicenter of global finance, pulsing through the veins of New York City. Yet, at their core, they share an undeniable allure. The thrill of risk, the pursuit of reward, and the deep psychological games that drive individuals to stake their fortunes on the turn of a card or the flicker of a stock ticker. Consider Sarah, a seasoned poker player at one of Las Vegas's most prestigious casinos. With every hand she plays, she calculates risks, reads her opponents, and makes decisions that could either multiply her stack or leave her with nothing. Half a country away, Jake, a Wall Street trader, faces similar stakes. With each trade, he assesses market conditions, predicts future movements, and places bets that could either swell his clients' portfolios or diminish their wealth. Different arenas, yet the essence of their pursuits is the same. A dance with uncertainty, driven by the hope of gain and the excitement of the unknown. Join us as we delve deeper into these two fascinating industries, exploring the parallels and contrasts that define the casino floors of Las Vegas and the trading floors of Wall Street. Welcome to a world where every decision counts, and the thrill of the game is the ultimate reward. In the heart of Las Vegas, amidst the glitz and glamour, the roulette wheel spins, a vivid symbol of the risks that pulse through the casino industry. Here, every game, from blackjack to slots, embodies the inherent risk of chance, where fortunes are made or lost on the turn of a card or the roll of a dice. Meet Maria, a gambler who's no stranger to the highs and lows of the casino floor. She knows that every game she plays is skewed by the house edge, an inbuilt advantage that ensures the casino, over time, always comes out on top. Contrast this with the world of Wall Street, where risk is woven into the fabric of financial markets. Here, investors like Tom grapple with a different kind of uncertainty, market volatility. Tom's investments are at the mercy of market fluctuations, influenced by a myriad of factors, economic indicators, geopolitical events, and corporate earnings reports. Like Maria, he faces the challenge of making decisions in an environment where outcomes are uncertain. But unlike her, his risks are tied not to games of chance, but to the ever-changing landscape of the global economy. Both Maria and Tom operate in realms where risk is a constant companion. Maria's world is governed by odds and probabilities, where the house edge ensures that the casino has a statistical advantage over the long run. Tom's realm is dictated by market sentiment and economic trends, where a news headline can trigger sudden swings in stock prices. In Las Vegas, Maria faces the tangible, immediate risks of gambling, each bet a direct encounter with the chance of loss. On Wall Street, Tom navigates an ocean of variables, his fortunes tied to the ebb and flow of market dynamics. Though the nature of their risks may differ, the underlying principle remains the same. Risk is the price of opportunity. For Maria, it's the chance to beat the odds and walk away a winner. For Tom, it's the prospect of investment gains in a fluctuating market. In both the casino and the stock market, risk and reward are two sides of the same coin, driving the endless quest for success in the face of uncertainty. Las Vegas, a city that never sleeps, where every casino promises a world of entertainment and leisure. This is where the thrill of gaming meets unparalleled hospitality, creating an ecosystem designed for enjoyment and excitement. Step into any Las Vegas casino, and you're enveloped in a kaleidoscope of sensory experiences. Here, Linda, a tourist from afar, finds herself mesmerized by the endless array of games. It's not just about gambling. It's about the show, the atmosphere, the chance to live a moment of pure escapism. But the allure doesn't stop at the casino floor. Fine dining, spectacular shows, and luxury shopping. Each element is a thread in the fabric of Las Vegas's entertainment tapestry, woven together to ensure that visitors like Linda leave with unforgettable memories. Contrast this with the pulsating heart of global finance, Wall Street. Here, the main activities are not designed for leisure, but for the serious business of trading and investing. Meet Alex, a Wall Street trader, whose day is a marathon of analysis, decision-making, and strategy. For Alex, the trading floor is a battleground where precision and speed are paramount, and the stakes are measured in billions. Here, the buzz is not from slot machines, but from the constant flow of market data, the ringing of the trading bell, and the rapid exchange of securities. It's a world where entertainment takes a backseat to the pursuit of financial growth, where every transaction is a calculated move in the complex dance of economic forces. While Linda seeks the thrill of chance in the heart of Las Vegas, Alex navigates the waves of market volatility on Wall Street. Two vastly different arenas, yet both are driven by the fundamental human pursuit of success and fulfillment. In this journey through the main activities of the Las Vegas casino industry and Wall Street's financial markets, we uncover a world of contrast, yet united by the undying allure of possibility and the relentless pursuit of the next big win. In the dazzling heart of Las Vegas, the casino industry thrives on a multifaceted approach to revenue generation. Beyond the roulette wheels and poker tables lies a vast empire of entertainment and luxury. For Cassandra, a casino owner, the games are just the beginning. Each slot machine, each bet placed at the tables, contributes to a river of cash flowing through the casino. But Cassandra knows that diversification is key to the casino's success. Her casino also boasts a five-star hotel, award-winning restaurants, and sellout shows. This blend of gambling and non-gambling revenue streams ensures a steady flow of income, making the casino a pillar of the local economy, providing jobs and attracting tourists from around the globe. Meanwhile, on Wall Street, revenue generation takes on a different guise. Here, the currency is not chips or cash, but shares and securities. Eli, a stockbroker, operates in a world where every transaction, every buy and sell order, generates commission. This transaction-based income is the lifeblood of Wall Street, fueling not just the brokerages, but also the entire financial industry. But it doesn't stop there. Wall Street's influence extends through investment banking, asset management, and financial services, driving revenue through advisory fees, management fees, and interest spreads. This financial engine powers economic growth, influences global markets, and shapes investment strategies worldwide. While Cassandra's casino leverages the allure of luxury and chance to draw in revenue from a diverse array of sources, Eli's brokerage thrives on the sheer volume of transactions and the complex web of financial services. Both Las Vegas and Wall Street are titans of their respective industries, each contributing significantly to their local and national economies. Their revenue streams, though vastly different in nature, underscore the importance of adaptation and innovation in sustaining growth and prosperity. As we peel back the layers of these economic powerhouses, we gain insight into the critical role they play not just in entertaining and investing, but in driving forward the economic fabric of society. Las Vegas, A city synonymous with gaming and entertainment operates within a complex regulatory framework designed to ensure the integrity of its casino industry. Meet Diana, a seasoned regulator with the Nevada Gaming Commission. Her role is pivotal in overseeing the operations of casinos, ensuring they adhere to strict standards that govern gaming activities. From licensing operators to auditing financial practices, Diana's work is essential in maintaining a fair and transparent gaming environment. Her efforts help protect players from fraud and ensure that the odds are never unfairly stacked against them. Over 2,000 miles away, in the heart of New York City, lies another highly regulated industry, Wall Street's financial markets. Ethan, a compliance officer, navigates the complex world of financial regulation set forth by the Securities and Exchange Commission, or SSEC. His role is critical in ensuring that his firm adheres to a myriad of rules designed to protect investors and maintain market integrity. From preventing insider trading to ensuring transparent disclosure of financial information, Ethan's work supports the foundation of trust that the financial markets are built upon. While Diana and Ethan work in vastly different industries, they share a common goal: safeguarding the interests of participants through rigorous regulatory oversight. Their roles underscore the importance of regulations in ensuring fair play, whether on the casino floor or in the stock market. In both Las Vegas and Wall Street, the regulatory environment plays a crucial role in fostering an atmosphere of fairness, transparency, and security. It's the unseen backbone that supports the vibrancy and dynamism of these industries, ensuring that they continue to thrive in a manner that's both ethical and equitable. Las Vegas, a city of dreams and dazzling lights, attracts a diverse crowd, each person drawn to the promise of entertainment, thrill, and perhaps fortune. Meet Sophia on her first visit to Las Vegas. She's here not just for the games, but for the whole experience, the shows, the dining, the spectacle. Casinos know that visitors like Sophia seek more than just gambling. They crave a comprehensive entertainment experience. To cater to Sophia and millions like her, casinos meticulously design their environments to offer a blend of gaming, leisure, and luxury, ensuring that there's something for everyone, whether they're here to place bets or simply soak in the ambience. Over 2,000 miles east, Wall Street appeals to a very different type of clientele. Here, the atmosphere is charged with a different kind of energy, the fervor of finance. Michael represents the quintessential Wall Street client, investors and traders who engage with the market not for entertainment but for financial objectives. They range from individuals seeking to grow their savings to institutions managing billions in assets. To serve clients like Michael, Wall Street firms offer a range of tailored services, from investment advice and trading platforms to complex financial instruments. These services are designed with precision to meet the specific needs of their diverse clientele, ensuring access to the tools and information critical for making informed investment decisions. While Sophia finds joy in the immersive entertainment of Las Vegas, Michael seeks growth and opportunity in the financial markets. Both industries, though worlds apart in ambience and appeal, excel in meeting the distinct desires of their clientele through dedicated, tailored experiences. In the end, whether it's the glittering casinos of Las Vegas or the towering institutions of Wall Street, understanding and catering to the unique needs of their clientele is at the heart of their success. It's a testament to the power of targeted service in captivating and retaining those they serve. In the heart of Las Vegas, the roll of the dice, the spin of the wheel, and the shuffle of cards define the essence of gaming. Here, chance reigns supreme, with each player's fortune left to the whims of fate. Meet Carla, who's spending her evening at the roulette table. She knows the game is designed with odds favoring the house, but like many others, she's drawn to the thrill of potentially beating those odds. To tip the odds in her favor, Carla employs strategies, though she understands that no system can guarantee a win against the house's edge. Her experience is a dance with chance, a hopeful quest for that lucky break. Contrast this with the strategic battleground of Wall Street, where outcomes are shaped not by the spin of a wheel, but by the forces of market dynamics and calculated decisions. James, a seasoned financial analyst, represents the strategic mind at work on Wall Street. For him and his peers, success in the markets is about analysis, foresight, and timing. Armed with research and data, James seeks to navigate the volatility of the markets, making informed decisions to outperform. His tools are not betting systems, but economic indicators, company performance metrics, and market trends. While Carla's fortunes at the casino are left largely to fate, James's success in the financial markets depends on his ability to decipher complex information and anticipate future movements. In both Las Vegas and Wall Street, participants like Carla and James engage with uncertainty, each in their own arena. One challenges the odds through chance, while the other navigates risk with analysis and strategy. Yet, both share the pursuit of favorable outcomes, employing their understanding of their respective games to tilt the balance, however slightly, in their favor. At the crossroads of risk and reward, two worlds collide. The high-stakes tables of Las Vegas and the strategic boardrooms of Wall Street. Both realms are fueled by the pursuit of gain, yet they diverge in approach and societal standing. Meet Emma, whose evenings are lit by the neon glow of the casino, and Daniel, whose days are governed by the fluctuating charts of the stock market. Emma's world is one of immediate outcomes, where chance dictates her fortunes. Daniel's domain, by contrast, is one of calculated speculation, where research and strategy play pivotal roles. Gambling and investing share the common threads of speculation and risk. Emma's decision to hit or stand at the blackjack table mirrors Daniel's decisions to buy or sell stocks in anticipation of market movements. Both are making bets on future outcomes, yet society often views their actions through different lenses. Society tends to romanticize Daniel's trading as a form of investment, a pathway to financial growth and stability, while casting Emma's casino ventures as mere entertainment or, at times, a reckless gamble. Yet the line between the two can blur, especially with the advent of day trading and speculative investment strategies that bear striking resemblances to gambling. Both Emma and Daniel employ strategies to manage their risks, Emma through bankroll management and game selection, Daniel through portfolio diversification and risk assessment models. These techniques underscore a shared understanding that managing risk is key to navigating their respective worlds. In the end, investment and gambling exist on a continuum of risk-taking behavior, each with its own set of rules and rewards. The debate over their differences and similarities is as much about the nature of risk as it is about societal values and perceptions. As Emma and Daniel continue their quest for reward, they remind us that in both gambling and investing, the stakes are high, the outcomes uncertain, and the allure of the game undeniable. In the electric atmosphere of a Las Vegas casino, time seems to stand still, yet outcomes unfold at lightning speed. Each spin of the wheel, each deal of the cards brings immediate results, win or lose. Rachel, immersed in the whirlwind of slot machines, experiences the casino's instant gratification. For her, the thrill lies in the immediate outcome, the chance to win big in the blink of an eye. This short-term horizon shapes her strategy. Quick decisions, based on luck rather than long-term planning. Contrast this with Alex, who navigates the financial markets with a telescope rather than a microscope. His investments in stocks, bonds, and mutual funds are measured not in minutes or hours, but in months, years, even decades. Alex's long-term perspective informs a strategy built on research, diversification, and patience. He knows that markets fluctuate, but he's guided by the conviction that, over time, well-chosen investments tend to grow. While Rachel seeks immediate gratification, Alex invests with an eye towards the future. Their differing time horizons influence not just their strategies, but their expectations. Rachel rides the roller coaster of rapid wins and losses, while Alex seeks to accumulate wealth steadily, weathering the ups and downs of the market. The concept of time plays a pivotal role in both the casino floors of Las Vegas and the financial markets of Wall Street. It shapes the very essence of each activity, from the casino's instant outcomes to the deliberate, calculated approach of long-term investing. Understanding this temporal landscape is crucial for anyone navigating these worlds, as it influences not just the strategies they employ, but the very nature of the risks and rewards they're likely to encounter. Las Vegas, a jewel in the desert, is more than a global entertainment capital. It's a powerhouse of economic activity. The city's casino industry is a vital engine driving local and regional economies, creating jobs and drawing tourists from every corner of the globe. Teresa, a hotel manager at one of the Strip's renowned casinos, witnesses the industry's economic ripple effects daily. From employment opportunities in gaming, hospitality, and entertainment to the surge in local businesses catering to tourists, her story is a testament to the casino industry's role in bolstering economic vitality. The influx of visitors not only fills casino coffers, but also spills over into local businesses, restaurants, and entertainment venues, creating a symbiotic ecosystem that fuels job creation and economic growth. Meanwhile, on Wall Street, the economic impact resonates on a global scale. This financial epicenter influences monetary policies, corporate finance, and investment trends worldwide. Michael, whose work involves analyzing and investing in global markets, plays a part in this vast financial network. His decisions can affect pension funds, savings, and the economic health of companies and countries far beyond New York City. Wall Street's reach extends to every corner of the globe, shaping economic policies, guiding corporate strategies, and influencing investment decisions. It's a testament to the financial market's pivotal role in driving not just national but global economic stability and growth. While Las Vegas and Wall Street operate in vastly different realms, their economic impacts are profound. Teresa's Las Vegas thrives on tourism and entertainment, providing a lifeline to local economies. Michael's Wall Street shapes financial outcomes across the globe, affecting everything from small businesses to multinational corporations. In their own unique ways, both the Las Vegas casino industry and Wall Street are indispensable to the fabric of economic growth and stability. From the vibrant streets of Las Vegas to the financial corridors of New York, each plays a crucial role in sustaining and energizing economies at both the local and global levels. In the heart of Las Vegas, casinos masterfully craft an environment of excitement and possibility. Every element, from the dazzling lights to the cacophony of sounds, is designed to tap into the thrill of the gamble, enticing visitors to play just one more hand, spin one more reel. Meet Elena, drawn into the vibrant allure of the casino floor. The psychological pull is undeniable, the chance to win big, the risk of loss, and the sheer excitement of it all. Casinos understand that the thrill of potential reward often outweighs the fear of risk, driving players like Elena to engage more deeply. But it's not just about the games. Casinos use complementary rewards, the design of the space, and even the absence of clocks to create a timeless zone where normal restraints fade away, encouraging continuous play. On Wall Street, the environment is different, but the psychological triggers are remarkably similar. Here, fear and greed are the dominant forces, driving the behavior of traders and investors alike. Simon, like many traders, rides the waves of market sentiment. Greed drives him to chase gains while fear warns him of potential losses. Wall Street's products and platforms are designed to engage Simon and his peers, offering real-time data, analysis tools, and trading options that cater to their desire to capitalize on market movements. The design of trading platforms, with their instant updates and alerts, taps into the need for quick decision-making, amplifying the emotional highs and lows of trading. It's a world where timing is everything, and the psychological impact of each trade can be profound. Both Elena and Simon are influenced by environments that heighten emotional engagement. Elena through the sensory-rich casino that promises instant rewards, and Simon through the high-stakes world of finance, where fortunes can be made or lost in an instant. The Las Vegas casino industry and Wall Street financial markets are adept at leveraging psychological triggers to drive engagement and investment. Understanding these triggers, whether it's the allure of a jackpot or the rush of a successful trade, reveals much about human nature and our complex relationship with risk and reward. On Wall Street, the pulse of the financial world beats with the rhythm of buy and sell orders. Here, market makers are the unsung heroes, ensuring the music never stops. Firms and individuals, they stand ready at the frontier of capitalism, buying and selling securities to provide the market with the liquidity it craves. Meet Max. His day is a high-speed chess game, where every move is a buy or sell decision that keeps the market fluid. By offering to buy and sell securities at publicly quoted prices, Max and his peers ensure that traders can execute their strategies smoothly without delay. Max's world is one of precision and strategy. He profits from the spread, the difference between the buying price and the selling price of securities. It's a delicate balance, managing risk while providing the liquidity that's the lifeblood of the markets. Thousands of miles away in the neon oasis of Las Vegas, the casino operates as the market maker of the gambling world. Unlike Max, the casino doesn't deal in stocks or bonds, but in games of chance. Lily's Domain is one where the house sets the odds, providing a platform for gamblers to test their luck against each other or the casino itself. Here, liquidity means ensuring that there's always a game for every player, a bet to be placed, a chance to win or lose. The casino, much like Max, profits from the odds, though here, it's the house edge built into each game that guarantees income over time. Lily's role involves managing this delicate ecosystem, balancing risk and reward to ensure the casino's profitability. Both Max and Lily operate in worlds where their actions provide stability and fluidity. Max's transactions enable the flow of capital across global markets, while Lily's oversight ensures that the thrill of the gamble remains a cornerstone of the Las Vegas experience. Though their functions mirror each other in purpose, to facilitate transactions and manage risk, their worlds couldn't be more different. Max navigates the financial markets, dealing in tangible assets and managing risk through spreads. Lily, on the other hand, orchestrates an environment of chance, where the risk is managed by the odds and the certainty of the house edge. In the end, whether on the trading floors of Wall Street or the casino floors of Las Vegas, market makers play a crucial role. They ensure liquidity and facilitate transactions, making both the financial markets and the gambling industry more efficient, dynamic, and accessible to participants. Max and Lily, in their respective domains, underscore the vital function of market makers in the economy's broader ecosystem. As we've journeyed together through the dazzling lights of Las Vegas and the high-stakes world of Wall Street, we've uncovered the fascinating parallels and stark contrasts that define these two iconic realms. From the thrill of the gamble to the strategic analysis of markets, the interplay of risk, reward, and psychological engagement binds these worlds in a dance as old as time. Both industries, though different in their mechanics, serve as mirrors to our desires, fears, and aspirations. They challenge us to consider not just the nature of risk and reward, but also the values and strategies that guide us in the pursuit of success, whether at the casino table or in the financial markets. For those intrigued by the allure of these industries and the strategies that can navigate their uncertainties, there's a wealth of knowledge waiting to be explored. One such treasure is Nicholas Darvas's insightful book, Wall Street: The Other Las Vegas, a compelling account that delves deep into the heart of investing, drawing on lessons as captivating as any game of chance in Las Vegas. If you're eager to learn more about the dance between risk and reward and how one man navigated the complexities of the financial markets with the finesse of a seasoned gambler, then I have something special for you. Head over to audible.com today and sign up for a free trial. As part of your trial, you can download Wall Street: The Other Las Vegas for free and immerse yourself in the captivating story of Nicholas Darvas. Discover the strategies, the mindset, and the discipline that defined his journey and could illuminate your path, whether you're drawn to the bright lights of Las Vegas or the dynamic world of Wall Street. Embrace the adventure of learning, and let the story of Nicholas Darvas inspire you to explore the depths of risk and reward in your own life. Click the link in the description below to start your free trial on Audible and take the first step towards mastering the art of the market. Thank you for joining me on this journey. Until next time, keep exploring, keep learning, and may fortune favor the bold.